Hello children, today let us discuss the first chapter of civics, Understanding Diversity. As we have different fingers in a hand, each one is different from the other. Likewise, all siblings from the same parent will be different from each other. In some children around your age have drawn the figures, you would not find any drawing similar to each other. The chances are that one drawing is different from the other. This is because each one has a unique drawing style. If you look around, do you see anyone who looks exactly like you do? We not only look different, but also differ in terms of language we speak, our culture background is different, our religious rituals we observe are different. Some of you may like reading, some of you may like playing, some may like drawing. Is there anyone whose interest matches with you exactly? Probably not. Some of you and your friends may not like reading the same kind of book. You can also observe that there are many languages spoken by the students or friends in your class. So we can observe that people are different from each other in many ways and belong to different regions, cultural or religious patterns. Some follow Hinduism, some follow Jainism, some follow Sikhism, and some follow Buddhism. And these are originated in India. India is known to respect the coexistence of different religions. Our Indian constitution accords equal treatment to all the religions and give the people of India freedom to practice religion of their choice. Christianity, Judaism, and Islam came to India several centuries later. Parsis, having settled mostly in and around Gujarat and Maharashtra, follow Zoroastrianism, which originates in Iran prior to the rise of Islam. We speak many languages in our country, though there are about 1,635 languages spoken across our country. The Constitution of India recognizes only 22 as official languages. Hindi in Devanagari script is recognized as official language of the Indian Union by the Indian Constitution. There are many different languages like Marathi, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Punjabi, Haryanvi, Bengali and Malayalam spoken in different states of our country. People are different. Religions have visited into and influenced and adopted this culture, resulting in a bouquet of cultures. This forms the foundation of cultural diversity of India. So, different kind of people who came from all kind of backgrounds and belong to all kind of religion and culture help to make India so interesting and diverse. These differences enrich our lives in many ways. Making friends is fun, isn't it? Do you think it would be easy for you to make friends with someone who is very different from you? There is a story about a small ranked boy who sold a newspaper and a small boy who goes to school on his bicycle every day crossing the same road. Every time when he cycled past, the paper boy would run after him, holding out the English paper and screaming out the evening's headlines in a mixture of Hindi and English words. One day he stopped by the pavement and asked for the Hindi paper. The paper boy's mouth fell open. He asked, "You mean you know Hindi?" "Of course," said the other boy, as he paid for the paper, and asked, "Why? What do you think?" The paper boy paused. "But you look so angry," he said. "You mean you can even read Hindi?" The other boy said, "Of course I can." This time, a little impatiently, He said, I can speak, read and write Hindi. Hindi is one of the subjects I study in school. Subjects. The paper boy asked, how could the other boy explain what a subject was to anyone who had never been to school? He said, well, it is something. As he began saying this, the lights at the crossing changed and honking of horns behind him blew 100 feet and he was pushed along with the rest of the traffic. The next day, the paper boy was there again, smiling and holding out a Hindi paper. Bhaiya, he said, aapka akhbar, ab bataiye ye subject kya cheez hai? He asked. The English word sounded strange on his tongue. It sounded like its other meaning in English to be ruled by someone else. Oh, it's just a something to study, the other boy said. And then because the red light in the signal had come on, he asked, have you ever been to school? Never, he answered. And he added proudly, I began working when I was so high, measuring himself against the cycle seat. First, my mother used to come along with me, but now I can do it all alone. The other boy asked, where is your mother now? But when the lights changed and he was off, I heard him yelling somewhere behind, she is in Miran with somebody. The rest was stronger. My name is Samir, he said, the next day. And very shyly he asked, what's your name? That was incredible. My name is Samir too, the other boy said. What? His eyes lit up. Yes, he grinned at him. And it's another name for Hanuman's father, you know, he said. So now you are Samir Ek and I am Samir Do, he said triumphantly. Something like that, the other boy answered and held his hand. Heart milav Samir Do, and his hand nestled like a little bird in the hand and he could feel the warmth as he cycled away. The next day he did not have his usual smiling face when he met the other boy. He said there was a trouble in Meerut. Many people were being killed. There is riots. There are riots going on. He said, looking at the headline, which read out communal riots. But he said, I am a Muslim, Samir, and all my people are in Meerut. His eyes filled with tears and did not look up when the other boy touched his shoulder. He was not seen at the crossing the day after, neither the day after, nor ever again. There was no newspaper in English or in Hindi, and nobody knows where Samir Do has gone. While Samir Ek is more familiar with English, Samir Do speaks Hindi. Although they both are at home in different languages, they still communicated with each other. They made the effort to do so because this was an important for them. Samir Ek and Samir Do also came from different religious and cultural backgrounds. While Samir Ek is a Hindu, Samir Do is a Muslim. Different religious and cultural backgrounds such as these are an aspect of diversity. In addition to their diverse religious and cultural backgrounds, there are other ways in which Samir Ek and Samir Do are different from each other. For example, while Samir Ek goes to school, Samir Do sells newspaper. Samir Do did not have all the opportunity to attend school. So perhaps you have noticed that there are several people in the area you live wherein they are poor and who don't have enough to eat and wear the and sometimes even they don't have place to live. This difference is not the same as one we have seen in the earlier. Here we are talking not to the difference but of inequality. Inequality comes when a person does not have the resources and opportunities that are available to the other persons. The caste system is another example of inequality. According to this, society was divided into different groups depending upon the work that people did, and they were supposed to remain in those groups. So if your parents were potters, you could only become a potter, nothing else. this system was considered irreversible. And because you were not supposed to change your profession, it was not considered necessary for you to know anything more than what you are needed in your profession. And this created a situation of inequality. Now let us understand what does diversity add to our lives. Just like Samir Ek and Samir Do, who became friends, you might have friends who are very different from you. You have probably eaten different kinds of food in their homes, celebrated different festivals with them, and tried out the clothes they wear, and learned some of their languages as well. You probably like reading and hearing stories and adventures about different animals, people, and even ghosts. Perhaps you even enjoy making up stories yourself. Many young people feel happy when they read a good storybook because it gives them a lot of ideas to make up more stories. People who write stories get ideas from all sorts of different places, like from books and from real life and from their imagination. Some may have lived in forests close to animals and chosen to write their own lives and friendships. Others read real accounts of kings and queens and might have written stories about love and honor. Some might have dipped into their own childhood memories of school and friends and wrote stories of adventure. So imagine if all the storytellers and writers that you have heard and read so far were forced to live in a place where all people wore the same two colors, red and white, ate the same food, maybe only potato, took care of the two same animals, for example, the deer and the cat, and to entertain themselves, played snakes and ladders. So, what do you think, what kind of stories do you think they would have written? Would it be not bored to do the same kind of things? So, children, by now you might have understood that in many ways in which you are quite like some of your classmates and other ways in which you are different from them.